In this video, we're looking at when a photographer should pay for a reshoot and when a client should pay for a reshoot. This is a question that was asked in the, I think it's called like the community tab on the YouTube channel. I'm always open to questions or things you want answering. I'll do my best to answer them. And this is a really good question. It's one that I hadn't thought of myself. And it's when something goes wrong, who pays for the reshoot? And it's a tricky question, and I'm going to try and give some examples and talk through this because there's a few ways to think about it. Now, first of all, let's talk about blame and whose fault it is. So there's two reasons why a reshoot is needed. One is that the photographer has fluffed it, or the stylist has fluffed it, or someone within the shoot team has made a mistake. And the other is that the client has misbriefed. And these are two very different things, but they can look the same. So it's very important when you have the brief to go, is this the brief? Is this the final brief? We've got version 2.7. Can we just confirm we're shooting to the same thing? Brilliant. And on the shoot day, are you happy with this? Is this okay? Yes, good, good, good. Because I've had shoots where afterwards they've signed it off on the day, emails have all been good. They've obviously then gone to a big management meeting and shown it, and someone's gone, what on earth have you done? This is not what we wanted. And they've turned around and gone, this is not what we wanted. And I'm thinking, you were happy earlier, why are you not happy now? This happens, and it happens not regularly, but you know, semi-regularly, especially when somebody, maybe a little junior, has been put in charge of the shoot. Now, that is obviously their fault when this happens, and you have to just go, look, we've shot to the brief, this is what you asked, this is what you delivered. Would you like to take this shoot, or do you want to reshoot? Now, depending on the client, if it's a client who has spent a lot of money with me, I will eat that reshoot up and I will do it for them. If they are a recurring client, they regularly do it. I've had clients where I've gone, look, don't worry about it. We'll sort this out. You tell your boss it's all underhand, or all in hand, more to the point, not underhand. That sounds a bit dodgy. Tell them it's all in hand and it will be fine. Don't worry, leave it with us. Just let's make sure we're clear on what it is you need. If they're a client we don't regularly work with, I'm probably not going to eat up the cost of a reshoot. Unless it was a huge campaign where they paid £50,000, £100,000, then I'd be like, yeah, don't worry about it. I will sort this out for you. Unless they've been particular a-holes about it, in which case I might just be like, well, sucks to be you, dig deep. So it's a bit of a, you know, looking at the long game, the big picture. If it's a local restaurant who wants a reshoot, I'm not going to do it because one, they don't pay much, and two, they're not going to book me again anyway. So they're just going to have to pay for themselves. If they want it, they'll probably go elsewhere. That's fine. Now, if I've made the mistake and if my work isn't good enough, and if we get to the end of the shoot day and they've not signed off because I'm not up to par, and this has happened as well, it happens to everyone at some point. You take on a job that's bigger than you can really manage. It happened to me about 5 years ago, maybe more than that now. I had to reshoot it and I had to bring in a bigger team because the retouching was out of my depth. The lighting was out of my... I had to bring in more people. It ended up costing me more than the shoot paid to reshoot it, and I made a loss. And that was entirely my fault. I dug deep, sucked it up, got it sorted. They're now a long-term client of mine. I work with them regularly. It happens. It's just one of those things. Now, one of the reasons that I'm such an advocate of shooting backplates and very methodical shooting, and I'll go into that in other videos in the future, I'm sure, is that sometimes it's not a reshoot that you need, but just more assets shooting to Photoshop in. Especially in the food and still life world, the commercial still life world, it's very easy just to make a new asset and add it in. And a lot of the times it's not a reshoot as much as it is a re-edit. Most of my images can be broken down piece by piece, and every single item in the image has been masked, separated, and the background's there, so we can move everything around and literally just recreate it. Maybe they don't like one of the, what should we think, an orange in the corner of the bowl. We've probably got other oranges we shot as options to move in and out. So there's always those options as well. So I rambled on a bit about this, but when you should do a reshoot is really a big picture question, and who should pay for the reshoot is also a big picture question. So it's all about, is it going to affect your long-term working relationship with this client? And do you want a long-term working relationship? I've got clients who I will never work with again. We have a blacklist of people. It's just like, these people phone, tell them we're busy because we don't want to work with them because they are such a nightmare, and there is so much reshooting that goes on and re-editing that we'd have to charge them such an extortionate amount, and even then it's just not worth my time because I value my time more than my money. Obviously there's a tipping scale to this, but I like free time to do my own creative work and to do this sort of stuff and, you know, not be tied down to just shooting 7 days a week. So it's all about, what are you trying to achieve and obtain from this? If it's your fault, do the reshoot. If it's their fault, think of the big picture. Can you afford? I mean, sometimes you can't afford to eat up the cost. And if that's the case, just go, look, I can't afford to reshoot this. If you can pay for all of the production team, I will work for free. my bad, I messed up, let's sort this out. Anyway, I hope this answers the question, and I hope it's of use to others as well. If you have any more questions, drop them in the comments below. I always check the comments, I nearly always reply to all of them, but there always seems to be one or two that I miss when I look back through it, but I'm going to get better at that, I promise. I'll see you next time.